All right. Well, let's see. You got me tonight because Ben's on the road. So you got Jason doing Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV show 170, if you can believe that. Hopefully Ben's gonna call in from the road. He's out traveling around visiting vendors. So let's get right to it. Vendor of the week is Lucky Dog Concessions. All right, Lucky Dog Concessions. Congratulations, Vendor of the Week. You can check them out at facebook.com/floppyrooster. That's right, floppy, Floppy, rooster. Looks like we got Ben joining in, Heather's joining in. So this gentleman trained with Matt and bought a cart and needs a little encouragement. So we're gonna help him out here, guys. So thoughts down in the bottom there. Let's let him know he's not alone. He's a new vendor in PA, just trained with Matt. So he knocked some time off that off his learning curve. I mean, you guys have heard me say, I think Ben's lost his mind, but he's the only vendor or manufacturer offering free training without the purchase of a cart. Most vendors or manufacturers, you need to buy a cart and you're still gonna pay for it. Ben's offering free training, soon to be in multiple locations. Okay, so I think the man's lost his mind. If you're on the fence thinking about doing this or possibly doing it a couple of years when you retire, definitely hit the link, go take the training. Okay, soon more locations that'll be coming to you next. All right, so who we got with us? Frankenstein joined, Carl, Daryl, Heather's here. Heather just put up the link. Thank you, Heather. That is to the new vendor for the week, Lucky Dogs at Floppy Rooster. Alien Hot Dogs, what's up, Manny? All right, guys, so let's get right to these questions. Question one, update on this new venture. Second day in my downtown area. I made about $50 yesterday and $13 today. So his money's going down. Disappointed, a bit deflated with reasonable amount of high foot traffic. Very clean, neat product. Could probably do better promotion with the flyers to the office surrounding the area. My prices are good, I don't know. I take any advice about where I should stand now. It just surprised me that it wasn't a success. All right, so I don't have a name on this one, so don't get discouraged. If this is a new location and you just started it, it's gonna take people a little while to get used to seeing you, okay? One, you need to make sure that your days are consistent. If you're doing Monday, Wednesday, Friday, it needs to be consistent. You can't just be all willy-nilly and all over the map, because what happens with that is people can't depend on you. And if I'm coming there thinking you're going to be there tomorrow and I don't pack my lunch, that's a problem, okay? Because now I'm pissed you're not there, so I won't be back to you. So consistency is the key there. You need to give it about 2 weeks. If you don't see it, come back in 2 weeks. Well, then you're out. You find a new location. You've heard me talk about backups to your backups. This is one of them. Got to have another location, okay? Whether this goes great or is a bust, you still need to be looking for continuing down the road, other locations, other buildings, catering, all those things, okay? It's a constant wheel turning, always going, looking for locations and possible vending, okay? So give it about 2 weeks, see what happens. Don't get discouraged. People here, you know, you can talk to guys on Vendors United and find there's days it happens, okay? It happens. I was at a location yesterday, a new business park, and I did 140 bucks. Three people in my truck didn't cover my expenses. So it does happen, all right? All right, so let's see. Mark Payne join us. Lane Slaymaker join us. Amanda, Mark Robbins, Nick Brochert. All right, Daryl, what's going on, brother?